Hello, I'm Kurt Browning, Pasco County Superintendent of Schools, welcoming you to our virtual graduation celebration to honor the class of 2020. You're about to hear from your principal and from your classmates. You're about to see each of your fellow graduates. It may be the first time you have seen many of them in months. Regardless of the highly unusual circumstances that we are living under right now, you are not defined by the events of the last 2.5 months. You are defined and bound together by all the years you have spent together and all the moments you have shared. You share a bond that will never be broken. I hope you enjoy this virtual celebration. I'm calling it a celebration because we intend for you to have the opportunity to walk across the stage to receive your diploma in front of friends and family at the date in August. So, enjoy the celebration, stay healthy and safe, and we'll see you in August.
My name is Jeff Morgenstein, and I'm the principal at Gulf High School, and it's my privilege to welcome all of you to the Gulf High School commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. As we prepare to open today's event, I want to be sure that our graduates are gathered together with their loved ones at home or by virtual meeting, and that you're wearing your cap and gown, your medallions, your honor cords, all of the things that you've earned as recognition during your time here at Gulf High School. We may not be at the main hall together right now, but that's just all the more reason to go all out, put on that graduation regalia, and immerse yourselves in what I hope will be a unique experience as Gulf High School Buccaneers. At this time, I invite all of our attendees to please stand. I'd like to introduce Catalina Romero, the president of the Gulf High School Executive Board, who lead us in the pledge to the flag. And then please remain standing as our Gulf High School band, led by Mr. William Rutherford, plays the national anthem. Please rise.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
It's so meaningful that we're gathered here today to honor our students who've worked so hard these past many years to arrive at commencement. Seniors, I wish to express my thanks to those who have been with you along this journey as we conclude our school year together. You've already been welcomed by our Superintendent of Schools, Kurt Browning. As well today, we'll hear from the Pasco County School Board member who represents our district, the Honorable Allison Crumley. From our school, allow me to recognize our administrative team. Assistant Principal for the Class of 2023, Mrs. Laura Luter. Assistant Principal for the Class of 2022, Mrs. Hilda Martin. Assistant Principal for the Class of 2021, Mr. Robert Strasser. The Assistant Principal for the International Baccalaureate Diploma Program, Ms. Cheryl Macri. And the Assistant Principal for our Gulf High School Class of 2020, Ms. Amy Mazurowski. I also want to recognize our school counselors, Mrs. Helen Lancashire. For IB and AVID, Ms. Kristen Lee, Mr. Patrick McKay, and for the Class of 2020, Ms. Angela Cotney. Two very important people as well are our senior class sponsors, Mrs. Ann Donlin and Ms. Liz Diaz. Please also join me in thanking every one of our Gulf High School teachers and staff members, but even more importantly, to the parents, extended family, and friends who are with us today. We congratulate and celebrate you because you have stood alongside our seniors throughout this journey. Thank you for that. It means a great deal to us and to them. Seniors, you have seen more in your 17 or 18 years than many people will experience in a lifetime. Perhaps that's because time and events seem to move so rapidly in our modern technological world. Or maybe it's because you've been confronted by the challenges from day one. There have been many references to the fact that the class of 2020 was born into a world reeling from the attacks on freedom that took place at the Twin Towers, the Pentagon, and in a field in Pennsylvania. You've only known a nation on alert, where brave Americans have been called to defend democracy at home and abroad. And now, we reach the final chapter of your high school career in the grip of a global health crisis. And yet here we gather to celebrate you, to recognize your achievements, and to know that the future will most certainly be better because each of you will step to the forefront and bring about changes that benefit others. Many years ago, another group of young people were born into a world that was turned upside down. They faced economic tragedy and a world war. They learned, they grew, they stood tall, and we refer to them as the greatest generation. You are now in the challenging, but also celebratory place to become our world's next greatest generation. In all you have known and all you have learned rises the strength of character that I see in each of you, that you can bring about a world of well-being, safety, and peace. So as you go forth from Gulf High School, remember the people here who showed up each day to make the future better for you. And in so remembering them, go out into the world and nurture the seeds that will serve to uplift humanity. It is what you must now do. All of us in attendance believe in you. Further in our program, we will be reading the names of seniors so we may celebrate them on graduation day. But first, there are others that we must note. I ask at this time that each of us take a moment to turn our attention to those who we wish could be with us today, but perhaps they're facing great challenges. And perhaps we should also think of those who time have taken from us. As we do so, please join with me to honor the life and memory of Travell Pettis, who would have graduated with us this year. Let us all take a moment of silence. Thank you. As many of you know, Gulf High School has a proud history hosting a highly recognized and decorated Naval Junior ROTC program. This represents the dignity and respect that our school places on those who dedicate themselves to a career in service to protecting our great democracy. Among our graduates today are several who have indicated their intent to join a branch of the military. I ask that we recognize them. Jeffrey Graves, United States Coast Guard. Emily Stacy, United States Navy. Matthew Brown, United States Marine Corps. Logan Grice, United States Army. John Cruz Amador, United States Army National Guard. And Savannah Hastings, United States Air Force. These are the seniors known to us at this time. Let us thank them and any others who choose to pursue this path. We express our gratitude. As well, it's my privilege to recognize and thank all veterans who have made great sacrifices for the benefit of our nation. We thank you. In just a moment, we'll be hearing from those Gulf High School students who've attained highest achievements in academics during their years of study. We offer two prestigious routes to graduation here at Gulf, through the traditional academic course of study and through the International Baccalaureate Diploma Program. Let me tell you a small, unique idea about each of the people who will be speaking to us today. Juan de Leon, our class of 2020 valedictorian, has distinguished himself as a student in our Gulf High School Game and Simulation Academy, one of our career and technical academies of which we're greatly proud. Nicodem Gazda, our IB valedictorian, he's an avid soccer player and loves cooking and graphic design. The IB salutatorian, Christian Che, is a National Merit Scholarship winner. And Antonio Papanikis, who is our class president, is also our outstanding senior. He's an athlete, and he's president as well of our HOSA Club for Health Careers. At this time, I'm pleased to turn our ceremony over to these students so that they can share with you their thoughts on this momentous occasion.
2,300 days. We, the Gulf High School Class of 2020, have completed more than 2,300 days of schooling over the past 13 years. We made it through the homework and projects, the exams and deadlines. We met new friends, teachers who inspired us, and all kinds of people. We even finished our senior year in the face of a worldwide pandemic. All of these trials and accomplishments have culminated in this moment. This moment, we can look back at how far we've come and imagine how far we can go. Wherever we go after graduation, whether it be college, the workforce, the military, or some unknown path, we'll take with us the skills and knowledge we've gained over the years. Thank you to the families, teachers, and administration who joined us on this 2,300-day journey, who supported us every step of the way. And to the class of 2020, I hope you'll take your experience at Gulf High School and use it to excel in your future.
Good morning, fellow classmates, teachers, family members, and anyone who's witnessed the class of 2020 get to where we are today. I hope everyone's staying safe, given the current situation we're in, because we've come a long way, and I'm sure all of us want to graduate in one piece. We all have probably a lot of time on our hands, too, which means it's finally time to catch up on all the sleep we've lost over the last 4 years, but also to reflect on the memories we've made at dances, meets, practices, and school trips, on the close friendships and bonds we've formed with people we've seen every day for thousands of hours, on what we've learned from our entire schooling experience, like the traditions which were here long before we first walked through those doors and had to sneak a snack out without the teacher noticing, and on who we learned from. Whether it be teachers, coaches, or other students, we've all had mentors to look up to and pave the path to get us on the stage and succeed in anything we set our minds to. I'd also like to give a special thanks to the parents, who've been a constant source of motivation and strength throughout our entire lives. I think one of the most important lessons we should take away from the time we've spent at Gulf is that no matter what, just have fun, enjoy the moment, appreciate even the situations which seem insignificant. We might not have another chance to shake hands with everyone we know in the hallway, or laugh and joke around the last 5 minutes of class with our closest friends, or chant loudly in a team huddle with adrenaline, spirit, and a deep respect for one another in the air. Each individual second had its own reason for being special and noteworthy, and I'm glad we were able to experience them all together. Here's to the exciting seconds to come in the future, to the new friends, new mentors, and new memories. Congratulations, Gulf High, Class of 2020.
Hello. I'd like to start off by saying, congratulations, Gulf High, Class of 2020. Despite all the obstacles, we made it. We didn't get to finish off our senior year the way we had hoped to, but let's focus on what went right instead of what went wrong. High school is where we all grew up into the young adults we are today, about to head out into the real world. The last 4 years pushed us to the edge, to a new frontier. It tested us academically, physically, mentally, emotionally, and everything in between. Now we get to put all that preparation to use as we move on to the next chapter, whether that be college, the workforce, military, or wherever the next step in life is for you. I'm proud of us and proud to be part of the class of 2020. I'd like to take a moment to address my IB class, the people I spent every day of high school with. Although all 39 of us are very different people, our experiences tie us together. During those painfully late nights spent writing my EE, one of the only things that comforted me was I knew there are at least 20 of you still up with me. To all the teachers and staff at Gulf High, I'd like to thank you for taking the time to make high school memorable for all of us. To my family and all the parents of the graduates, I speak for everyone by thanking you for the sacrifice and commitment you put into raising us into the men and women we are today, for always supporting us in our endeavors and encouraging us to succeed. I hope you all make the most of your lives, because you have so much potential and each day truly is a gift. Be happy and love those around you. I know this class will go on to accomplish great things. Thank you and good luck, Class of 2020.
Hello and welcome, Class of 2020. My name is Antonio Papanikas, and I've had the honor of being your Gulf High School class president for the past 4 years. We are brought together today in an unusual way that none of us would have ever imagined. Throughout these past 4 years, each and every one of you can agree that it hasn't been necessarily easy. All throughout high school, we have been the underdogs, the ones that others have doubted the most, the ones that sank in order to swim, and the ones that have proved everyone wrong. Through guidance, support, and self-motivation, we have all earned to be where we are today. This isn't the end of a journey, but rather the start of an era. Freshman year, coming into your first year of high school, brought stress, nerves, and the pressure of being the newbies at Gulf High. From taking that first pop quiz to finding a place to sit at lunch. As the year progressed, we experienced our first football game, went to our first pep rally, and danced away at homecoming with excitement and curiosity of where life was going to take us. Between all of these events, we realized freshman year was just the beginning. Then sophomore year came around. By now we were in the hang of things. This was the year that most of us wanted to get involved because of what we had witnessed in the year prior. Whether it was joining a sports team, the band, ROTC, or any of the other great programs at Gulf High, this was where we wanted to show what we could bring to the table. By junior year, we were past being rookies, we were in the pros. We knew the ins and outs of the school and what was expected from us. However, junior year was one of the tougher years, if not the toughest. We had a lot of expectations and big shoes to fill. With that being said, I'd say we still had an amazing year as we killed it at the lip sync competition, remained undefeated in Powder Puff, and made it to our first prom ever. We were able to accomplish more than we had thought. Finally, we are left with senior year, the year that we waited for all throughout high school, the year that let us be the big dogs of the school, and the year that showed everyone just how great we were. This year was our year. Yes, it did get cut short early, and yes, we missed out on some end of year events. But I feel that we are so much more than that. We have grown as individuals and together able to surpass all the odds against us. This virus is just one more test, a test to see how ready we are for the real world and if we are able to sacrifice what we are for who we will become. I would like to take a moment to thank the teachers and staff who have pushed me to be the best that I can be. I would also like to give a special thanks to my family. With your constant support and motivation, I've been able to overcome more than what is shown on high school transcripts. You have taught me determination, perseverance, and more importantly, hope. Hope for what is still to come and hope for excellence of those around me. I love you all and I appreciate you more than you may know. So as we conclude the most memorable time of our lives, I leave you this message. Each and every one of you is going to succeed in life. We have put in the hard work and effort, and we are not going to stop now. You are capable of doing anything you set your mind to, and I believe that we can do it. As Danny Duncan once said, some people call it luck, but I call it dedication. I look forward to seeing you all at our 10-year reunion. Thank you for this opportunity, and thank you, Bucks, for pulling through as one of the strongest classes to make their way through this milestone. Stay strong and go Bucks.
I would like now to introduce some wonderful educators. Ms. Jennifer Dixon, Mr. Patrick McKay, and Ms. Kim Thurer, who will present the names of the Gulf High School Class of 2020.
Hello, my name is Jennifer Dixon. Since 2010, I have taught economics and financial literacy and psychology at Gulf High School. It is truly an honor to be here today to announce the graduates of 2020. Sebastian Abney. Xavier Acevedo. Chloe Afriat. Alexia Aguirre Vargas. Marcus Akrish. Kelvy Almeida. Marissa Infuso. Riley Infuso. Carla Angeles Hernandez. Jordan Asper. Tiaja Aturist. Abigail Ayers. Sarai Baez Rosario. Kayla Baker. Jarelli Baltazar Cano. Robert Banks. Sinkoy Barkley. Jose Bastida. Tyron Batchelor. Justin Batista. Diana Baksijay. Brody Becker. And now Boganovich. Marquesia Bennett. Andrew Bichet. DeAndre Bezuidenhout. Cody Biggs. Kiona Blake Climes. Caitlin Blethrode. Jada Beltright. Nicholas Bogus. Brady Booker. Nicholas Bourget. Bailey Bova. Layla Bove. Brooke Bowen. James Boyd. Malik Britton. Alicia Brown. Derek Brown. Jonathan Brown. Zaniah Brown. Owen Bussler. Ashley Butler. Janet Butt. Mark Bychin. Angela Kadavid Palido. Adia Kane. Veronica Kansel. Victoria Kansel. Shania Canestrero, Daniel Cantha, Anthony Cardone, Elijah Carr, Yudislady Carrillo, Emily Catalonia, Kirsten Chambers, Kati Chandias Pineda, Vanessa Chavez Crisitomo, Yulisa Chavez Lara, Rhea Choksi, Jeffrey Christensen Jr., Kane Clark, Olivia Clark, Samantha Cody, Sarah Cody, Christopher Collins, Emily Colon, Destiny Cook, Angelina Cooper, Patience Cooper, Caitlin Cortlett, Alexander Cortez, Lily Cowan, Abby Crane, Alexia Cruz, John Cruz Amador, Brenda Cruz Perez, Christian Che, Myrna Cuevas, Jan De Silva, Dominic Denault, Haley Dogtree, Malik DeValle, Juan De Leon, Christian Delgado, Tig Diggins, Kyle DeMango, Ethan Dittman, Kennedy Doan, Boyana Dolinich, Jason Dutton Jr., Kevin Dwee, Victoria Escalante, Gabriela Esparza, Brandon Estrada, Alyssa Everhart, Venetia Fajardo, Jeremiah Fernandez, Matthew Figueroa, Nayeli Figueroa Perez, James Fink, Juan Flores, Chevy Frain, Kaylee Fritz, Adam Gefsky, Damian Galarza, Jessica Garcia, Arthur Gardner, Nicodem Gazda, Madeline Germain, Knowledge Gillespie, Michael Glagowski, Clemente Godo Rodriguez, Mia Gottfried, Madison Graham, Caleb Graveline, Jeffrey Graves III, Allison Gray, Erica Green, Bobby Gregor Jr., Logan Grace, Jean Guillen Portales.
Greetings, Buccaneers. My name is Patrick McKay, and I'm a member of the school counseling team at Gulf High School. I'm honored to be here with you today and sharing this momentous life event for you. Without further ado, let's continue recognizing the class of 2020. Triada Holbig, Ryan Hamilton, Shane Hartman, Savannah Hastings, Elijah Haas, Layla Hembry, Sean Henniger, David Hernandez, Justin Hicks, Haley Holtke, James Charles Holton, Kamoy Hutchison, Olivia Jackson, Rick Jelm, Carson Johnson, Alfred Jones Jr., Talia Jones, Memphis Judy, Lydia Kalergis, Derek Kaplan, Evan Kaplan, Emmanuel Karras, Connor Kelly, John Kelly, Jay King, Kale Cupsick, Brittany Lassert, Andrew Lombardo, Savannah Lanier, Tyler Lakidara, Daisy Laura Baltazar, Jenna Latimer, Scarlett Leal, Darlene Ledford, Kylie Ledman, Steve Lee III, Mason Liston, Jordan Loans Benton, Arvani Longworth, Malcolm Lopez, Esmeralda Lopez Ramirez, Donovan Lowe, Raven Lovejoy, Luke Lukey, Aiden Luna, Alexandria Macedonio, Cameron McKinnon, Jason Maldonado, Teresa Mann, Austin Manning, Jania Marcellus, Yoel Maria, Alte Marcal, Aaron Marrero, Carlos Martin Meza, Erica Martinez Corona, Coralis Martinez Nazario, Kyle Mason, Aaron Masters, Andrew Maxim, Jack McAuliffe, Sydney McBride, Kiara McMillan, Sean McSorley Jr., Crystal Mendez Aviles, Antonio Mentor, Dallas Mary, Daniel Mertz, Thomas Micklow Jr., Trent Milanich, Gloriana Milan, Elijah Miller, Isaac Miller, Summer Miller, Alex Miranda, Angel Miranda, Sierra Molnar, Kobe Monroe, Gina Montano, Amanda Moore, Gregory Moore, Olivia Moran, Madison Morano, Jason Morgan, Thomas Morgan III, Zamarius Morgan, Ileana Muniz, Teresa Murphy, Zachary Navio, Peter Nicola, Alex Nemeth, Jarly Nee, Megan Nolan, Nicholas Novello, Gabriella Ocampo, Jonathan Ogden, Damian Orsini Jr., Ezekiel Ortiz, Irelise Ortiz, Joseph Osbar, Angel Otero Ramirez, Holden Overmeyer.
Greetings and salutations to all of the wonderful Gulf High School seniors, families, and friends. I'm Kim Thur, and I could not be more proud to be a teacher at Gulf High School, as well as an alumni from the class of 1978. Please know that we miss all of you very, very much. It is my honor to be able to present to you the remaining graduates of the class of 2020. Congratulations. Joe Meleles, Paban Rivera, Giovanni Palma Hernandez, Antonio Papanikis, Jacob Peckham, Edward Pachulis, Jennifer Peterson, David Peterson, Tyler Peterson, Zane Petrie, Jacob Pett, Kevin Petto, Jessica Pileggi, Shania Polite, Mia Pons, Catherine Porto Carrero, Lily Primrose, Ian Provenzano, William Prusha Jr., Matthew Quinn, Ian Ragon, Mariah Ramovich, Hirsch Ranparaya, Sydney Rast, Stephanie Ravenscroft, Butter Rebass, Kayla Reed, Julia Riccardi, Emily Rice, Madeline Rice, Montana Riggle, Amanda Rivera, Chelsea Rivera, Derek Rivera, Fantasia Rivera, Sitlali Rivera Lara, Emery Robbins, Sarah Robertson, Jose Rodriguez, Kenny Rodriguez, Luis Rojas, Catalina Romero, Jacqueline Rooney. Cole Rose. Isabel Ruisi. Yusuf Saeed. Jasmine Salgado. Ivana Sanchez. Joelle Sapp. Julia Scales. Catherine Chinelli. Jaquisha Scott. Eamon Salim. Jessica Selk. Ariana Saraganis. Gianna Serpi. Melissa Serrano Torres. Prashi Shah. Cheyenne Shattuck. Jenna Short. Evan Sims. Alyssa Singh. Elvin Scarrett. Maya Skinner. Lisi Small. Una Sabat. Arthi Solayapan. Houston Spencer. Emily Stacy. Corbin Steele. Daniel Sturmer Jr. Porter Stipp. Kristen Suitors. Leah Talanga. Josie Tanner. Tiger Tash. Melanie Taylor. Tanae Taylor. Tommy Taylor the Third. Paige Teal. Pedro Tesna Contreras. Jakira Thomas. Tyrus Thornton Jr. Andrea Tolles, Audrey Tolles, Gabriel Tony Jr., Mackenzie Topics, Maria Travorich, Riley Van Dyke, Olivia Van, Jonathan Vargas, Maya Vargas, Fernando Jose Vega Morales, Aaron Venuto, Liam Viudez, Nathaniel Vidoris, Cassandra Wallace, Raina Weiner, Andrew White, Brian White Jr., Hayden Wiley, Alejandro Williams, Jasmine Williams, Kenneth Winters III, Serenity Wise, Daviana Wolf, Larry Wood III, Ashley Worsham, Tasabi Yagub, Dominique Yamonico, Jacob York, Jacob Young, Maria Yusuf, Caitlin Zajeka, Christina Zielish,
I'd now like to invite two people to the podium. To certify our graduates, we welcome Pasco County School Board Member for District 4, the Honorable Allison Crumley. And immediately following, our Student Government Executive Board President, Catalina Romero, will instruct our seniors in the traditional act of the turning of the tassel from the right side to the left. I ask that the Gulf High School students participating in today's ceremonies please stand.
Graduates, school board members, parents, and guests, I certify at this time that each of the members of the class of 2020 here today has met the Florida State and Pasco County School Board requirements for high school graduation participation.
My name is Catalina Romero, and I serve as Student Government's Executive Board President.
families, friends, and my fellow seniors, it is with great pride that I address you as the newly certified graduates of Gulf High School's Class of 2020. Now let us turn our tassels in recognition of our achievement. Congrats, everyone. We did it.
Parents, families, friends, and educators, I am so proud to present to you the Gulf High School Class of 2020. Graduates, each day you make us all the more proud. One thing is certain, we will never forget this class and how each of you rose to face the challenging times. As we conclude today's ceremony, please stay with us for the playing of the Gulf High School alma mater and for senior shout-outs. Thank you for being with us.